Geostar is really reaching into, you and I talked off camera, blood cells. And there were three reasons why blood cells were so important. Tell me.
Yeah, so that's wonderful. I was talking about the importance of immune cells and all these things to treat the cancer. But I was thinking continuously, is it possible to really differentiate this stem cell into the blood cell? It was always a question in my mind whether we made blood using stem cell or not. Because as we know, there are three main problems for the blood transfusion. First, we have to match. Second, there is not enough blood available every single time. And third, when we transfuse blood from one person to another person, there is always the chance of the transfer of the disease. We always has less availability of the blood. So you will be surprised to know from all the collection agencies like Red Cross and all the non-profit organizations or profit organizations.
Right.
We collect almost 100 million unit blood each year.
100 million units of blood, okay, is donated through whatever. Yeah.
And still 80 to 90 million units
short
is shortage.
Wow.
Okay. So I was thinking, is it possible to really differentiate the stem cell into the blood cells? So of course it is very, very, very tedious job and it's a very complex process because blood first inside the body, it comes to the blood stem cells, and then after blood stem cell, it goes towards the mature blood cells like red blood cell or white blood cell or platelets and all these things. And again, I was a little fortunate and that I could able to see the mechanism, how this blood differentiate in the body from the stem cell. And that I published in 2003.
Oh my goodness.
Four, okay. Like 15 years back.
Ages ago.
Okay. And again, it was working at University of California, San Diego Medical School. So that was published. And so I could make the hematopoietic for the blood stem cell in the lab. Then I was thinking, is it possible to make the red blood cell? Because as I told, there's three problems for the blood cells. First, always the amount is not enough available in, if needed. Second, we always need match.
Like, yeah, type.
Yeah.
Are you A, B?
A, B, yeah. all the blood group. You cannot just transfuse blood randomly, okay? You have to match. And then third, there is always chance of the transfer of the disease from one human being to another human being. Whatever test
that
you do,
didn't know was there.
Because there are certain unknown things which you don't know. So I was thinking, working at UCSD Medical School, is it possible to make the blood using a stem cell? So I started differentiating the stem cell into the blood cell, and I was lucky that I could successfully differentiate this stem cell into the blood stem cell. And because I was trying to develop the treatment for thalassemia, sickle cell anemia, and blood-related diseases, so I thought, is it possible to change this blood stem cell into the different kind of mature cell, like red blood cell, platelets, or other things? And again, to inform you, in 2006, I published the paper, 2003, 4, 6, several papers, that how blood can be differentiated from the stem cell. And I generated real red blood cell, mature red blood cell in the lab. It was patented through UCSD. And now we, Geostar has the patent, exclusive patent. And now we are trying to make this in the bioreactor to make it available to the masses again. Our focus is always the masses. So now we are looking for partnership and funding to go for the mass production and applying to the US FDA and other
going through the steps that we need to go through for the government, that we need to
work with the agencies, as I told you.